I guess if you're watching this video, you'll probably have seen one of these before. This is a Cambridge Audio 551P Phono Stage for turntables with a moving magnet cartridge. And it's a very good budget Phono preamp. I used to have its bigger brother, the 640P, which has the moving coil input too. Oh, I should say that the 540P is pretty much identical to the 551, except that the 551 has a power switch on the front. That's it. So this video applies to the 540 as well. And well, really, the 640P, the 651P, the CP1, the CP2. If you started out with one of these, it was a good choice. And you'll likely have been perfectly happy with it. When the upgrade-itis bug bites, and you upgrade the rest of your system to more resolving equipment, you may start to notice more graininess and a narrower and flatter soundstage than other sources. As I said, these are great boxes at their price point. Well-engineered, neat casework, but designed to that price point. And that's totally understandable. Cambridge Audio aren't stupid, and they know their markets. So these are well-reviewed, well-respected, and hold their value. Actually, a good used 540 or 551 may cost you around £60 to £70 on eBay. That's around 70 to 80 euros or 75 to 90 US dollars. Bargain. So you've upgraded the rest of your system and it's time to move on to a more exotic Phono stage, right? Well, maybe not. This one actually belongs to a returning customer. I modified his integrated amplifier a month or so back, and he was so impressed with the transformation that he wanted his Phono stage upgraded too. Well, Matt, I think you're gonna like this. In my pre-upgrade listen with the 551P, I actually thought it was better than I remembered from a previous time I did an upgrade on one of these. Of course, audio memory is not totally reliable, and my own system has been upgraded a lot since then. So I could be hearing things my old system was masking. Anyway, I still found it grainy, a bit shrill and harsh sounding, with a narrow soundstage. Given the clarity of Matt's amp, this would definitely be noticeable. So, to the bench! Outgo the cheap and nasty, or as Danny Ritchie at GR Research might say, the cheesy components, the cheap general purpose electrolytic capacitors, and the cheap film caps. They're replaced with some good quality ones, more suited for high-end audio, decent electrolytics for power supply duties, Panasonic and Nichicon fine gold, some noise snubbing, op-amp upgrades, and clarity cap polypropylenes in the direct signal path. No more electrolytics for output coupling either. As you can see, good quality film capacitors are pretty big, and fitting them on an existing small PCB can be a challenge. But like here, in a lot of cases, can be done neatly and professionally if you have the patience. How does it sound now? Well, I designed the upgrade, I chose the components, and I didn't expect it to be as good as it now sounds. The graininess and harshness I mentioned before, that's gone. It's smooth and relaxed, and the soundstage has grown wider and there's more depth. I expected all of those things, but not quite as much, if you know what I mean. To put it in some recognisable context, the trumpet on Dire Straits is right across the river from the E.O.D. Brothers in Arms album. It's sharper and more clearly focused, some distance behind everything else that's going on, all of which is clearly separated. The strings on the steel guitar on The Man's Too Strong are as crisp and as clear as you would want. To be honest, I'd be happy with this in my system after modification. And my Phono stage is the monster that is the Musical Fidelity KW Phono. So, do you have to spend a fortune to get high-end audio? Well, about maybe 12 years ago, I spent a pretty penny on my KW Phono. It replaced a Cambridge Audio 640P. What an audio fool I was. I could have just modified the 640P and got maybe 80% of the performance of the KW. You know what this means, though? I'm going to have to modify my KW Phono to make it better still. One for another day, maybe another video, after I finished the TriVista 21 upgrades. The moral of this video: remember, a good example of one of these can be had for a reasonable price on eBay. A Maudifi Stage 2 upgrade for it is about. There'll also be a kit. So if you have the skills and you want to do it yourself, or you're outside of the UK, then that will only cost around £140, approximately $175 or €165 and some of your time to do the upgrade. Yes, I just listened to the B-side of this back-to-back on each Phono stage, but for this to get that close to the performance of a Phono stage costing over £3,000 when new, which would you go for? Don't forget to replace your World War II with a decent Royal one. That makes a significant difference. There are a few salad of these out there now, or if you want a full DIY project, ask about that in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Feel free to give it a thumbs up if you liked this. And if you like my more realistic, value-led approach to high-end audio or hi-fi upgrades and upcycling, please subscribe to the channel and click on the notification bell to be kept up to date as I post new stuff. Stay safe. I won't see you, but you'll see me next time.